I had a bad influence in my life because of my father. He drank and he never stopped me from doing it. I got tempted into it. He just never cared about me, neither my mother. Because my mother always tells me that when you are small, in second standard, you started working in the shop, in the pan shop, you know, tobaccos and pan shop. And by working there and, you know, going forward, I got tempted into it and I started smoking cigarette. My father, he doesn't care. You know, at least twice in a week, I wouldn't go to the school just because I had to sit there, because my father would just go away just to drink alcohol and come back and sleep home. Like, he didn't care about anything. He didn't care about my life. He didn't care about his life. You know, it was a time of 2014, and like, he was at home and he was talking about people. You know, the shop was shut down that time, and he started drinking more alcohol, and he said people are you know, going there in the shop and just doing whatever they want because the shop is closed, just using for toilet and all. I said, don't worry about it, someday, give me some days, everything will be okay. And he just didn't listen to it. I just came out.
What do you think of your dad now? What are your thoughts about him?
Yeah, like, sometimes I wish he was, you know, he was alive. And yeah, sometimes I feel I should have had my father alive. So that, and I would definitely, you know, have had force him to leave drinking alcohol or change his life. I would have definitely done it.
You think you're now in a position where you could have
yes.
changed his life a lot?
Still, I think he gave me a right direction. Because of him, I am what I am now. Because of his wrong steps, I have taken good steps and improved the family overall. My mother used to go to a farm just to earn money, because my father, he didn't spend even a single money for my education or food. And she used to get 50 rupees a day. That was the only an income source I had in my home. But she is a very hard worker. Like, she is brilliant. When I had a bad situation at my home and couldn't help my mother, couldn't help my father to, you know, just get out of this drunk. When I was crying there, when my mother was beaten, he came to me and he was asking me what is happening and all. He saw this and he helped me out. He gave me some money. So get some food, get some medicines for my mom. And that's the day I came across football. after two, three days, he talked to me and said, would you like to play football? Would you like to do this? I said, yeah, I would like to play football, but I have never played it. I felt quite good because I never think of anything, what is happening at my home and all. I just concentrate on football and playing the game. And then on, I become a part of Slum Soccer. And after a year of practice, I was selected then again for the state tournament of Slum Soccer. By that time, my football became really good. I was told that you've been selected for the Homeless World Cup, but I didn't know anything about it. I started crying immediately because I said, international tournament and I'll be representing India. So he said, yes, you'll be representing India. From that point, my life became slightly better. Never think about flying in the aeroplane or going to a foreign country, going to abroad. I was staying in the five-star hotel there called No Hotel, the biggest hotel in Poland. And yeah, it was just amazing experience for me. I felt like dreaming, you know, a dream coming true. It was just amazing. I never thought that the country that I would visit would be like this. The opportunity I got, the money that spent on my journey, a short journey, helped me out to figure out my long journey. That gave me everything, the perspective towards my life. When I came back from the Homeless World Cup, my life, my family completely changed. I saw many people and talking about community change. I didn't realize what that actually mean. When I talked to Abhijit, like he explained me very well. He said community change means having, going in the community, changing children, or making them play football, and making their lives better. I said, can I do this? He said, yes, you can do it. And he was also happy. He shook my hand. And when I came back, that's how I started focusing on myself. And the other side, I didn't know that I was also improving myself. So I started focusing on them, but Slum Soccer started focusing on me. So both ways, I was also improving myself as well as others. So it was a life-changing event, I would say, in my life. But also in my life, I have observed that if you help somebody else, you will definitely get helped by somebody else. Without empathy, you are not growing your community. You are not improving the lives of others. You are not developing your country mainly. Like my childhood was completely like very, very tough. I don't even think of it. Because nowadays my future is gonna be good, my present is good, I will build my future.